Hi guys, welcome back to K-World for the 13th episode recap of Hometown Cha-Cha-Cha. With a plot spoiler alert, let's get to the video. It's Du-sik's birthday, and Hye-jin makes some seaweeds for him. Min-sun is surprised to see her cooking, and the mess she has made to do that. Hye-jin forced Min-sun to taste it, and goes off to see Du-sik. Min-sun struggles with the taste, and complains to herself, about how salty it is. When Hye-jin gets to Du-sik's house, she finds the entire neighborhood gathered to celebrate his birthday. Du-sik tells her that his birthday has become sort of an annual event, and they won't stop, no matter how much he asks them to. Everyone gathers up to cut the cake, and gets Hye-jin to join him. On seeing them, Yeon-kung reminisce on their wedding day, but Joong-chul is far back with food stuffed into his mouth. Hye-jin and Du-sik heads back in, and Du-sik notes the insulated bottle Hye-jin holding onto. On hearing Hye-jin made it herself for Du-sik, he right away tries it out, and acts as it's so good. She gets so excited on hearing it tastes good, and wants to give it a try. But Du-sik quickly claims he wants everything for himself, without giving Hye-jin the chance to taste it. Ha-jung sees the two playing with the insulated bottle, and so she sneaks out of the house. When Du-sik and Hye-jin brings watermelon for everyone, each come up with awkward excuses and leave. Du-sik and Hye-jin laugh off, because they're well aware that everyone else is giving them privacy. On their way back home, Gongjin walks fast because he wants to go home quickly and rest, but Yeon-kung struggles to keep up with him. She suggests to go on a day leaving Bora in Ha-jung's care. To her disappointment, Gongjin points out that she can't even walk properly, so it's impossible to go on dates. Hye-jin and Du-sik on the other hand are finally alone, and they decide to have wine together. She notes a new bottle fermenting on Du-sik's alcohol shelf, and Du-sik tells her that he's fermenting it for her. Hye-jin quickly pastes a label on it to make sure it's hers. The next day, both Young-guk and Young-hoon shows up while Ha-jung and some of the ladies are cleaning. Ha-jung and others start to complain about the watermelon and the coffee the two men has brought, and get them to help with the cleaning. During the break, Du-ha tells Ji-won that Sung-hun is refusing to eat again, and blames it on her. He points out that Sung-hun can't eat, because he's too upset about Ji-won leaving. Sung-hun comes to Ji-won's defense, and Du-sik overhears them talking. Having enough of it, Ji-won decides to eat alone. On noting a depressed Sung-hun and Du-ha, Du-sik takes them to his house for a meal. Du-ha marvels how beautiful Du-sik's house is, and notices the herbs he has collected. He recognizes one of the herbs and tells them that he used to take them to his paraplegic father. While Du-ha do the dishes, Du-sik joins Sung-hun outside and explains to him that he looked way more depressed than the time Hye-jin dumped him. Du-sik tells him that Ji-won once told him she admires Sung-hun, but maybe she's admiring him not just as a good colleague, but something more. Hye-jin gets a visit to her clinic from two of her college colleagues. They're a tour for the clinic being empty, and that it looks exactly as they pictured. Hye-jin gets lost in words, so Min-sun does some angry stretching that makes Hye-jin take her colleagues out to chat. They go to Chung-jae's cafe. Again they begin to complain how tacky the cafe looks. The talk then shifts to Hye-jin's ex-boyfriend, that he's marrying a rich girl. They ask Hye-jin when she's going to get married, and wonders if she at least have a boyfriend. Hye-jin quickly says she does, and just then Du-sik walks into the cafe. The two colleagues recognize him to be Hye-jin's stalker from the photo. Hye-jin quickly cuts in before Du-sik could pick up the conversation. They invite Hye-jin and Du-sik to play golf. Hye-jin tries to talk out of it, but Du-sik agrees. Next morning, Du-sik borrows golf clubs from Young-guk. Hye-jin's friends get stunned to see Du-sik in different cloths, and how handsome he is. To surprise them much more, Du-sik plays golf better than any of them. After the playing, the four of them sit down to rest, and the talk shifts to Du-sik. He admits that he's a part-timer, but he lives his life to the fullest. The two friends gets more and more impressed on Du-sik. When he's gone, they ask Hye-jin when she's going to marry him, since dating at this age should be taken seriously. On their way back home, Hye-jin tries to make Du-sik reveal what he did during his mysterious 5 years away from Gongjin. She comes up with many hypotheses, so Du-sik finally reveals that he did a simple desk job. She asks him if he has plans to go back to Seoul, but Du-sik plainly tells her he hasn't, because he loves Gongjin. Hye-jin is clearly not satisfied with the answer, but drops the conversation. Young-guk secretly watches Ha-jung as she works hard in her restaurant. Tired from all the work, she falls asleep. Young-guk secretly walks in, and do all the dishes, so by the time Ha-jung wakes up, the kitchen is clean. Du-sik on the other hand watches suit hanging on his closet, and remembers a woman whom he calls Nuna, buying it for him. He wonders why he can't throw it out. Yoon-chul has taken Min-sun on a date, and he admits that he looked up for the best movie and the best restaurant before taking her there. Min-sun tells him that she enjoyed both the movie and the meal because she was with Yoon-chul, not because they were good. She advised him there is no menu for dating, and just to follow his heart. Moved by her words, Yoon-chul quickly pulls her into a hug. The next day, the news reports about a typhoon striking Gongjin in the afternoon. Yoon Kang asks for Gum Chul's help to bring in all the fruits outside. Gum Chul complains but does so. Yoon Kang holds up her frustration, but when he refuses to tie her shoelace and tease her for being a kid, Yoon Kang breaks out and yells at him, asking if he thinks childbirth is easy. Nothing Gum Chul says calm her down, and she chases him out of the store. Ji-won and Sung-hun are working on their last shoot. She tells him that working with him was so exciting, and she felt sparks every time they come up together with a new idea. When Sung-hun asks her if she's not feeling any sparks, and the day why she's leaving, Ji-won tells him that she's been feeling more sparks lately, and that is why she's leaving. Ha-jung tries to tape windows to prepare for the typhoon. Young-guk arrives just in time to catch her from falling when she slipped from the chair. He helps her out with the windows. After it's done, Ha-jung and Young-guk sits down for a coffee. She brings up about him doing the dishes without telling her, which is so unlike him. Young-guk is surprised to know that she knew it was him, because there was foam left all over the sink. He apologizes for being a horrible husband, and sincerely tells her to consider going on a blind date with the man her friend told her about. She grabs his coffee, and throws it into the sink, and asks him to leave. She also tells him that she has already agreed to go on the blind date. Gum Chul visits Du-sik, and complains about Yoon Kang's nagging. Du-sik makes him realize how hard things must be for Yoon Kang, and that he should be more concerned about her. Gum Chul storms out of the house on realizing everything Du-sik says is actually true, but leaves behind his phone. Hye-jin finds Yoon Kang still in tears, and helps her clean the store, and tie up her shoelace as well. Hye-jin takes the time to talk to her, and makes her feel better. Suddenly her water breaks. Hye-jin calls Gum Chul, but because he left his phone, Du-sik answers it. Du-sik quickly rushed to the store. Du-sik calls Yoon Chul hoping to know the whereabouts of Gum Chul. Instead Yoon Chul tells him that every road is blocked, because of the typhoon. So Hye-jin tells Du-sik to take them to her house. Du-sik makes a call to Gari, and asks for any tips on childbirth, since Hye-jin will be delivering the baby. So she gives Hye-jin advice on what she should do. Gum Chul on the other hand rushed to the supermarket with Yoon Kang's favorite fruit. He's surprised to see the store is open, and Yoon Kang is gone, so he makes a call to Yoon Kang, and learns that she's in labor. He rushes over to Hye-jin's house. In tears, Gum Chul helps Yoon Kang with her labor. Bara wakes up to the sound of thunder, and starts to cry calling out for her mother. Ai-jun finds her crying. She tells him that she's worried about her mother because childbirth is very painful. A lightning strikes and Ai-jun tells her that he once read if you make a wish when the lightning strikes, it will come true. So both Bora and Ai-jun pray for Yoon Kang and her newborn child. After a while the storm gets settled, and Du-sik hears a baby crying. Gum Chul apologizes to Yoon Kang, and promises to be a better husband for her as he shed tears of joy. The couple thank Hye-jin, and ask her to hold the baby. Even though she hesitates, she holds her. Du-sik also walks into the room, and is delighted to see the newborn baby. Hye-jin back hugs Du-sik as he prepares tea. He tells her how proud he is of her, and now everyone in Gongjin will come looking for Hye-jin, and not Du-sik for any emergencies. She admits that she feels so drained and sleepy, so Du-sik takes her to his house. Du-sik tugs her in his bed, and decides to sleep in the sofa, but Hye-jin convinces him to sleep with her. Du-sik is the first to fall asleep. Unable to sleep, Hye-jin decides to take a walk in the house. She goes through his bookshelf and finds a family photo tucked inside a book. Du-sik finds her looking at the photo, and grabs it from her hands. She asks him who those people are in the photo. He just plainly tells her that it's some people he know. Hye-jin gets offended, because Du-sik refused to open up before giving vague answers, when she has showed him her everything. Du-sik refused to talk, and just say he's sorry. In the epilogue, Bora and Ai-jun has visited Du-sik's house with a hedgehog. Bora asks him if he likes pets, to which Du-sik says he loves them. When she asks him, then why refuse to take care of the hedgehog, Du-sik sadly replies, that he's afraid of saying goodbyes. That's it for this video guys, thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, and see you next time.